Welcome back to AgriTalk as we wrap things up today here at the National Association Farm Broadcasting Convention in Kansas City. Later this afternoon, as I mentioned earlier, I'll be talking with Secretary of Agriculture Tom Vilsack. We understand he may have some announcements to make, so we look forward to finding out what he may be bringing as far as news. One of the things I'll be asking him about, of course, is the ag spending situation and possible cuts. I want to talk about that now with Mary Kay Thatcher, the Senior Director of Congressional Relations for the American Farm Bureau Federation. Good to see you. A lot of things up in the air, aren't there?
There are. You know, I've been kidding people today that I probably could come back and do an interview in 2 hours and I might have something different to say. Things are just moving so quickly.
I guess the big question right now, will the Super Committee accept the Ag Committee's offer of $23 billion in cut?
I think as long as the Ag Committee comes up with a reasonable proposal, it doesn't get loaded up like a Christmas tree, yes, they will. Now, there's still the opportunity, if the Ag Committees don't come up with this, that they're going to come up with their own cuts. And I suspect the easiest thing to do when you're trying to find cuts of $1.2 trillion is just take a pencil and strike through that one line that says direct payments are available and say $35 billion, we're done. And think about that, Mike. What if we lose $35 billion now and then we have to come back and write a farm bill next year with no money? How do you provide a safety net then?
And that's what's at stake really right now.
It absolutely is. This isn't a pretty process. I mean, you know, we'd like to have more transparency. We'd like to have more time. But given the fact that you have to cut money now, and then if we don't do the farm bill this year, we're going to have to come back and cut again next year. We just have to get this done in the next few days.
You and I were talking about this. There are a lot of people in this country who say, why have any farm programs? Why have any support? Have producers just buy crop insurance? That's their safety net. Why is there anything else? This debate that's going on right now kind of opens the door for those people to try to push to get that done. What is agriculture's response? What do we need to respond to that?
Well, that's why we need to make sure we have a very responsible position. You know, there are a lot of folks that just look at the fact that the ag economy is doing better than the economy in general, and they say, just eliminate all subsidies. Well, you and I know that the cure for high prices is high prices, and they will come back down, and there are going to be years in the not-too-distant future where we're going to need a safety net a lot more than we need it now. So we need to make sure that we clear up some of those problems, and we have some concerns about some of the ideas that are pending out there now and about the idea that even with a shallow loss program, people could double dip. They could get money from crop insurance indemnities and the shallow loss program. I think that's the wrong signal to send out there. The major papers will have that double dipping in the paper right away. I think there's also concerns about having programs, a program that works for corn, a different one that works for cotton. You know, we got away from the government giving signals to farmers about what to plant, and we made sure in the mid-90s that the marketplace did that, and we got to make sure that we keep that premise as we move forward.
We're hearing more. We're talking things we used to talk a lot about, target prices, things like that. I mean, are we maybe looking at going back to some of the things that we have, as you say, gotten away from?
Certainly in the last week, a lot of the discussion in those closed-door meetings have been for considerably higher target prices for rice and for peanuts and for wheat. And in fact, if some of the numbers you hear are true, we're going to have WTO cases thrown at us. It'll be just like the Brazil cotton case again. But more importantly, you're going to get such high prices out there that you're going to encourage people from planting soybeans to move back into peanuts or to do other shifts. And if indeed that's what the market's saying, that's one thing. But to have the government telling you that, that's wrong.
What do you think about, from what we hear, it sounds like very few people on the Ag Committee, just the top leadership, really putting together this proposal, and even members of the Ag Committee's not really up on what's being proposed here. Is that a dangerous way to do a, you know, a proposal like this?
You know, it's like making sausage. It's not something you want to see done. But, you know, think about the alternative. You got about couple of months here to really write this farm bill. It's $23 billion. Could you really get 60-some members of the House and Senate Ag Committee in a room and have them make progress? No. So I think this is the best alternative. And certainly this implosion that we've had in the last few days about what's happening was inevitable. As the details started to leak out, people who hadn't been in the room were going to say, whoa, let's talk about this. So I just hope that the four principals can get things back together and come up with something realistic that they can send. And it seems to me that this is just kind of too big to fail. We've got to get this done in the next 4 or 5 days.
What do you think is going to happen on the dairy side and the reforms that, you know, that Colin Peterson is pushing for? Do you think we're going to see something along those lines?
I do. I think every dairy producer out there says what we have now isn't working. 2009 were such awful prices, and you know, it looks like dairy prices are going to come down again. Hopefully not that much, but come down again. So I think we've got to try something new. This gross margin idea with supply management thrown in, I think you'll see something very similar to what Colin Peterson proposed in the final bill.
Coming back to row crops, what do you think the philosophy, should we base support on yield or revenue?
Well, I think it has to be revenue, although, you know, the problem is that as you have a revenue product from a farm program stamp moving forward, and you have 75 or 80% of crop insurance now covering revenue, it's really hard to make sure you're not covering the same losses. And as those two programs converge, I think we're going to have to be very careful. And if we had all the time in the world, we'd look at lots of different ways to make sure we're still covering those concerns, but we're not overlapping them.
Why can't we, the whole industry, the country, come up with crop insurance products that will pretty much take care of, we keep hearing we have to keep improving, there are these holes, there are these problems. Why is it so elusive, so hard to really fix crop insurance?
Well, I think the administration's working really hard on this. You're looking at getting an announcement really soon about yield trends and updating those, and certainly everybody agrees that the yields in agriculture have been increasing pretty tremendously, and crop insurance hasn't kept up with that. But I think they're looking for ways to better keep up with it. I think the problem is always going to be that in the South, it's always going to be a riskier place to grow commodities, and therefore premiums are probably always going to be higher in the South than they are in the Midwest. And consequently, you're always going to have more support for crop insurance out of the Midwest. But we're looking at lots of good options. I think the administration is coming up with some. Again, I think we can improve on the crop insurance program, and you're likely to see some tweaks in this bill that will indeed do that.
We've heard the proposal CRP acres, the cap may be lower. You think that'll happen?
Very, very likely. We got 32 million acres now. You know, I don't think there's a chance we're ever going to put that much land aside anyway, especially with corn and bean prices. But I suspect after this, you're going to have more like 25, 26 million acres. Now, a farmer who has a contract will be safe. We're not talking about breaking any contracts. But some of the better land, the Tier 1 and Tier 2 land, when it rolls back out, this proposal would just say, don't re-enroll that land.
So what do you see happening? I mean, do you think the Super Committee will meet their deadlines? And will that be something you think Congress will go along with, or are they going to try to just do the bare minimum, punt it down the line, which Congress kind of likes to do? What do you think is going to happen?
I'm still a believer that there's an 80% chance that we finish our $23 billion portion, we put it in the big bill, and while I kind of laugh at the idea that $3 or $4 trillion was ever a hope, I don't think we'll get to $1.2 trillion. I think we will find $700, $800 billion that people can agree on, and that package will move forward, and that'll be a good thing, because then when we have these sequestration, the across-the-board cuts, we'll only have to have it for $400 or $500 billion instead of $1.2 trillion.
But if the Super Committee comes back and says $23 billion is not enough, you got to go much higher than that, what does that do?
Oh, I think that throws us into a tailspin, especially when we're 10 days out from when the Super Committee has to meet. But again, I think the Super Committee has already winked at the Ag Committees. And as long as we send them a reasonable proposal, $23 billion will be sufficient.
I guess we'll find out soon.
Very soon.
Good to talk to you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Mary Kay Thatcher, Senior Director, Congressional Relations for the American Farm Bureau Federation. As she said, stay tuned. This thing could change moment to moment as we wait to hear right now from the Super Committee and see where we go from here. All right. We'll wrap up our broadcast for today, but much more to come tomorrow here at the National Association Farm Broadcasting Convention. And as I said, we'll have some comments from Secretary of Agriculture Tom Vilsack. He'll be talking with us this afternoon. We'll have those comments for you on tomorrow's program. We'll see what announcements he brings with him here to Kansas City. Thanks for joining us. Be with us again tomorrow. This is AgriTalk.